Good morning, one and all. We have discussed TIG welding in the last class. In today's class, we'll discuss about MIG welding. MIG welding is metal inert gas welding. Here, we use the metal as a rod in order to perform the welding operation. Here, we use the shielding gas, mostly an inert gas, metal inert gas. So, it is an inert gas. We use the inert gas to form a protective layer over the welded surface. So, here the electrode is consumable and this is the wire feed. So, you have continuous feed of electrode from here. This is the contact tube and this is the shielding gas. So, the material here the positive is given to the electrode and negative is given to the workpiece. The material will get melted and will be poured over the workpiece. The shielding gas will form a protective layer over the MIG welding. Next one is atomic hydrogen welding. In case of atomic hydrogen welding, we have two tungsten electrodes and we have supply of hydrogen here. Here hydrogen will act as a shielding gas and this is the weld bed. It means through which means where the welding is taking place. So here we have two tungsten electrodes, one connected to positive and another connected to negative. When these two electrodes are brought together, because of the ionization of gases which are present here, an arc will produce. If it is a thin metal, you need not to go for a filler rod, but if you have a metal of larger size, then we need a filler material to fill the gap between both the metals. So in order to join both the things, the arc will be used to melt the junction, it means the surface areas of both the metals, and filler rod is used for a supplying of extra material to the weld. Next one is forge welding. In case of forge welding, we heat the material 90% to 90% of its melting temperature. It means we don't allow it to melt and get evaporated or melt to and get to its liquid state. We just heat it red hot and we hammer it. So it can be a rod, it can be a plate, it can be anything. We just heat it and we hammer it in order to get the weld. So this is a solid state welding process and the applications are: it is used for joining steel and iron. It is used for manufacturing of gates, prison cells, etc. It is widely used for cookware. It is used to join boiler plates before introduction of other welding processes. It is used to weld weapons like sword, etc. It is used to weld shotgun barrels. So these are the applications. The advantage is it is very easy and the cost of equipment is very less for small welding pieces. Here in this process you can join both similar and dissimilar materials. The properties of base metal and the weld metal will be same and no filler material is required for forge welding operation. But at the same time, we have some limitations for this forge welding operation. Only small objects can be weld and larger objects require large presses and heating furnaces, which is not economical. High skill labor is required because if you hammer it excessively, then it will create damage to the welding plates. You cannot use this type of process for mass production and it is suitable only for the iron and steel. The process is very slow. As it is a time consumable process, we are not preferring this type of processes in these days. Next one is submerged arc welding. As the name itself indicates, the arc will be inside. So here you have some granule particles which are poured over the surface of the base metal and there is an electrode which passes in that. So here also, because of ionization of gases, arc will produce and the electrode will get consumed and the welding of both the metals will take place. But here you have two tubes. One tube is to pour the granule particles to protect the layer and another tube for collecting the granules. Okay, but the thing is here you cannot see the welding as it is getting submerged into the granules, you cannot see the arc which is producing. That is a major defect with this type of welding. But the thing is, the granules which you are using will act as a protective shield, and it protects it from reacting with the reacting with the oxides present in the air. But as you cannot see the welding, we cannot know, we don't know whether the welding is taking place properly or not. So these are the advantages and limitations of arc welding process. Next one is resistance welding. Resistance welding is a fusion welding where no flux or filler material is added. The heat required for welding is obtained by heating effect of the electrical resistance of the joint, and hence it is named as resistance welding. So the formula for heat generated, H equals to KI square RT, where H is the heat generated, I is the electrical current, T is the time for which the electrical current is passed, R is the resistance at the joint, and K is the constant to the account of heat loss at the joints. Generally, low voltage and high current is passed in short time, that is 0.25 seconds, in order to get the resistance welding. This resistance welding is of different types, like spot welding, resistance seam welding, projection welding, upset welding, and flash welding. In case of spot welding, you have two electrodes and you have two plates like this. And now, when both the electrodes come closer, there will be some resistance developed between both the, because of the plate, as the plate is offering some resistance at the junction here, the heat is generated and these two metals will get joined. So this is the spot welding. And in case of seam welding, you have two rollers like this and you have two plates. When these rollers are running over the plate, the welding process, the welding will take place. Next one is projection welding. In case of projection welding, we'll be having dimples like this over any one part of the plate, and the electrode will be moving over these plates. And now when you get the sufficient heat, these dimples will become flattened and joint will take place between both the welds. And next one is flash butt welding. In case of flash butt welding, you have one fixed electrode and one mobile electrode. And now when these electrodes are coming closer, there will be some flash between the fixed electrode and mobile electrode. As a result, at the junction, you'll get the joining of both the metals. So it means you'll get the weld at this area. Thank you for listening. In the next class, we'll see about thermite welding, explosive welding, laser welding, and all. Thank you.